most polymers fail in two manners, either in ductile or brittle manner. There are many factors which influence if a polymer will fail in ductile or brittle manner. In this video, I am going to talk about these two failure modes and main cause of leading these failures. A good understanding of these failure mechanism is important for material selection and also for product design. So, failure is basically separation of a body into two or more parts, or permanent distortion under application of load or stress. As I already mentioned, there are two types of failure mechanism, ductile and brittle failure. The process of failure mainly involves phenomena of crack initiation and crack propagation. Due to stress concentration or void formation or other factors, crack initiation takes place and it propagates depending on the nature of material and amount of the stress applied. In ductile failure, a crack moves slowly and is accompanied by an appreciable plastic deformation before actually breaking apart. Plastic deformation is irreversible or permanent deformation, whereas brittle failure occurs with elastic deformation, where crack propagation occurs very fast. This type of deformation is irreversible and temporary. Now the question is, what is deformation and what do we mean by plastic and elastic deformation? As we know, when force or stress is applied on a plastic material, its shape changes. This change in shape is known as deformation. During deformation, the intermolecular forces of the material oppose the applied force. If the intermolecular force is large enough to resist applied force, the samples returns to its original state when load is removed. This is known as elastic deformation. If the intermolecular force is not sufficient enough to overcome the applied force, then the sample undergo permanent deformation. It cannot go back to its original shape even after the force is removed. This type of deformation is known as plastic deformation. At microscopic level, elastic deformation occurs in the form of bond stretching and rotation, which is temporary. The best example for elastic deformation comes from elastomers such as elastic rubber. When we pull the elastic rubber band on the ends, it stretches. If we stop pulling it, it comes back to its original shape. This shows phenomena of elastic deformation. But when pulling force is very high and it breaks, the material shows plastic deformation. Plastic deformation is permanent and irreversible deformation. It occurs due to breakage of limited number of chemical bonds between atoms that make up the material. If we look at stress-strain curve of a polymeric material, we can see that amount of stress required to deform a polymeric material changes with extent of deformation. As elastic deformation occurs at very low strain value, which is less than 5%, and plastic deformation occurs at relatively high strain value. In elastic region, stress increases linearly with strain, which indicates material's resistance to deformation. At certain point, which is known as yield point, material's resistance to deformation decreases. As a result, material can be easily deformed. In this phase, we can see that strain increases without increasing stress, indicating stretching or elongation in material. The yield point is the point that indicates the limit of elastic behavior and the beginning of plastic behavior. So, those plastic materials that fail at very low strain are known as brittle material, and those who require high energy to break or fail at high strain are known as ductile material. The mechanism by which brittle and ductile material fail is known as brittle and ductile failure. The main cause of brittle failure is stress concentration, that is present in the structure of molded or manufactured product. Discontinuities that develop during molding or service life initiate crack formation. The discontinuities can be in the form of notch, corners, holes, splints, laps, folds, large inclusions, cracks, crystallographic planes, etc. A stress concentration, which is also known as stress razor, is a location in an object where stress is concentrated. An object is stronger when force is evenly distributed over its area. So, a reduction in area, for example, caused by crack or void, results in localized increase in stress. So, stress concentration is an area in a material or a sample where force is not evenly distributed and force accumulates there. When force in that area become larger than what the material is supposed to withstand or designed to withstand, it starts to crack from there. As we can see here, in case of sample having a void, the line of force are not straight near the void. The line of force has high density near the void compared to rest of the area. Therefore, material starts to crack from here. Brittle failure is worst type of failure because it involves the sudden failure of the material by rapid crack growth immediately after the crack initiation. This type of failure is also known as fast failure. A classic example of ductile failure is tensile specimen. Ductile failure provides some warning before failing. The material deforms, elongates and decreases in cross-section before failure. Elongation and decrease in cross-section refers to necking. That means usually the material undergo necking before breaking, whereas brittle failure is quick and no prior warning. This sample starts to fracture due to formation of microvoids in the necked region. These microvoids grow in size and begin to join together or coalesce to produce an internal crack. The final separation of the cross-section occurs by shear rupture. In ductile failure, there is absorption of massive amount of energy. Therefore, crack propagation occurs very slowly before the fracture. That is why plastic deformation occurs at a very high strain value because material undergo large deformation before failing. So, we learn about two extreme behaviors of a material, which are brittle and ductile failures. But many of the polymeric materials fails in ductile to brittle manner. That means many polymeric conditions can make a plastic partially ductile and partially brittle. Therefore, most of the plastics show intermediate ductility unless they are deliberately made to be very ductile or very brittle. This ductile to brittle transition depends on microstructure, molecular structure, time, temperature, and percentage strain. In summary, we can say that brittle failure undergo with appreciable elastic deformation and ductile failure occurs with plastic deformation. Elastic deformation is reversible and temporary, whereas plastic deformation is permanent and irreversible. Brittle failure occurs at low strain and ductile failure occurs at high strain. Stress concentration is the main cause of brittle failure, whereas ductile failure occurs due to void formation. Ductile failure gives prior warning before failing, whereas brittle failure is sudden and fast. So that's all for today's video. If you like our video, please subscribe to our channel Polymer World. Thank you.